Actually look on the inside. You can lean in. Give me reality of what's going on. You see all the flammable stuff in the fog.
Yeah.
That's a bay.
Yeah, man. Mm-hmm. Welcome to Shaky Town.
That's another one.
That's how to eat, actually.
Right there.
Well, he keeps a hammer under his blanket.
He's prepared.
The shelter don't have enough funds to help the people in the community. You know what I mean? They're taking a lot of the cities and the state is taking away from the shelter system and these programs.
Let me ask you something. I got to find this out. How did you know to come here?
Well, I came here through the VA.
Through the VA? The VA notified you about this outreach?
No, I was in the Maintenance General right here. I was on the medical floor. And what they did, they had a brochure.
Refer you here. They refer you here. I'm in the same boat as these gentlemen here.
Right. Right.
This is one of the places that they house veterans. They have a veteran side, and they have just a regular side for the guys that's not veteran. Mm. And I myself am a veteran. I served 6 years in the Army Marine. My thing is, not saying that I don't agree with everything you said,
but supposed to,
he hit the nail on the head when he started talking about drugs. But my issue is mental health. I believe we have a mental health priority issue in this country as a whole. Mm-hmm. And we turn our back to it. And the more we turn our back to the problem, the bigger the problem is going to get. Until we address that situation, until we address our homeless veterans, I served 6 years for my country.
Sorry.
I was willing to die for my country. Mm-hmm. But my country has turned their back on me. All I want is a push start. I don't want no handout.
Right.
You understand? Because I'm a very hard worker. I have a portfolio in my book bag right there. You understand? I had a job in Hollywood. I was living in Somerville with a female. She and I just do not get along under the same roof. So I took it upon myself to come up here. Some of us that are here are not here because we on drugs or we on alcohol.
Right.
Some of us are here because we going through something.
Right.
You understand, my brother?
Right.
I have to get my own place with my own key for myself. I'm tired of trying to help somebody else benefit from my love and care, and I get messed on in the process. So I got to alleviate that now. But I'm not here because I'm strung out on drugs.
Right.
I can pass a drug test.
Right.
You understand?
Yes.
I had to quit my job, man, and that hurted me.
Mm.
You understand? Because I didn't have a way to get back and forth to work when I left her to come up here. And that really hurted me because I have an 18-month-old daughter that I have to try and support. You see? But leave it up to her. I'm the evil one. You know, because I don't want to argue, I don't want to fuss, and I don't want to fight. You understand? I've been diagnosed with PTSD, bipolar, and depression.
Yes, man.
I've been walking around with depression for 20 years and didn't even know I had it, man. Educate. We need to educate our
brothers.
That's
right. That's what we need to do.
When you don't have education, man, you don't know. What you don't know can kill you.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? I want to work and support myself. All I want is a push start. Somebody to get just be in my corner and help guide me in the right direction. I'm an ex-offender as well. It's certain companies around here won't even give me the time of day. I've been clean. I've been out of prison for over 10 years now. I think the state of South Carolina only going back 7 years, so I have that in my favor. That's how I got this job in Hollywood, making $14 an hour. You tell me, brother, what man in his right mind want to turn down a job making $14 an hour to come live here? Not saying that this is this is the bottom of the totem pole, which it is for some of us. But some of us need a wake-up call. Some of us need to be here, and we need to apply ourselves. When we come here, they have programs. The first time I came here was last summer. I remember this brother because he helped me get in here. I slept out here 3 days before I could get in because they only take so many people. They only have so many beds. The fire department only let them sleep so many people. But everybody won't get in tonight. And I'm gonna try to get in line now, tonight. But my thing is this, man. We have a mental health issue in this country that's really, it's out of control. It's been out of control. When I joined the military in 1980, I graduated from midterm, went in the military, made sergeant in 2.5 years. That was going to be my career, but I had to come home to take care of my mother. And I have no regrets because she lived 6 years. She didn't raise me. A lot of us come from broken homes. A lot of us, you know, we just was misled from the start. You understand? But I grew up in a spiritual home, man. And now I'm going back to what I was taught as a child, to trust in God. You understand?
Yo, no Charleston, please, buddy. What's going on?
Tucked under an overpass out of sight is a place to disappear at night. There's not much peace and quiet, but 42-year-old Solomon manages somehow to rest here.
What led you to sleep under this bridge tonight?
No place to go.
So Solomon makes do. Not enough room to stand. Even so, plenty of people have found this hidden spot. Right now, two of them claim the space.
It's just me and a guy named Levy.
Solomon is a man with a job, a cell phone, but no place to call home. There are hundreds just like him. Following worn pathways into wooded areas, North Charleston police have discovered their campsites. Police have marked them on maps in places you would never suspect. An official government count of homeless camps in January located hundreds. We toured about a half dozen in the early morning hours and found campsites with improvised comforts. A veteran's camp has mirrors for shaving and checking his teeth, and a heater for frosty nights. Most other homeless camps have more primitive methods of keeping warm.
How'd you find this place?
Deep in the woods near City Hall, Mike and Larry are basically permanent residents. The problem with all the campsites, they're on private property, and most are a nasty mess. Police are trying to clean them up and move people like Mike and Larry out, but the squatters say there aren't many places they can go.
Why not go to the shelter?
They're full.
Really?
Yes, ma'am. They're full.
Some of the homeless choose to live this way, but every man we talked to on this morning said it's no way to live.
I hate it. Can't get clean. Can't take a bath.
We're just trying to survive. That's all.
Survive hoping to find their way out of an impossible predicament.
It's just me, you know, my pride. You know, I can get out. I can do it. I know I can do it. I know I can.
Fish full of mercury.